I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
And this is the Wizard Product Review on this week's show.
So what's up first, Dave?
First up this week, Craig, is by Matthew Beech, the guy that fooled Penn and Teller.
Yes, Matthew Beech, the man that I called an idiot. And then we had him on the sofa and we hugged and embraced and he kissed us.
Did he kiss me?
He kissed you as well, yeah.
I don't remember that. Okay, right, okay. It was late, though. Well, late night
like
in Blackpool.
2 o'clock in the bar, yeah.
It's Spreadwave 2, isn't it?
Spreadwave 2, yeah. I mean, there's very little difference between Spreadwave 1 and Spreadwave 2. There is a small difference, which we'll get to. Didn't this win an award with Fissom?
Yeah, well, it's won loads of awards. Not only the Penn & Teller Award, the award for you fool the greatest magicians on the planet award.
Yeah, which isn't too bad. They also won a Fissom Invention Award 2006.
In 2006, I was actually there at that convention when he did that.
Really?
Yeah. Well, I didn't see his award or I didn't see his entry, but I was at the convention somewhere.
Probably in the bar.
Probably in the bar or the dealer hall, yes. But synopsisize the effect.
Okay, well, basically, if you haven't seen it, and I can't imagine many people that haven't, the idea is really simple. He brings out a clear pack of cards, you know, like a blank pack of cards. He has a card freely named, and it is freely named, no force.
No.
He then takes out the cards and he says the blank on both sides. He starts showing them very, very cleanly. He spreads through, and there's three cards that are actually printed in the deck. He takes those three cards, and the first one says your, the second one says card, the last one says is, or something like that, your card is. And then he spreads through the deck, and the name of the card they freely named, is revealed in the spread of cards.
It is
a beautiful
moment.
It does
look good.
It looks amazing.
The difference between Spreadwave 1, Spreadwave 2, is the original Spreadwave, for some reason, didn't have
yeah,
the aces.
Yeah, you could only... one of the beautiful things about this routine is it really is a freely named card. Now, the only problem was, in Spreadwave 1, you couldn't name an ace. So if the spectator...
How
named,
did you get around that in Spreadwave 1?
There were ways. What he did
How?
Is...
Told me there were ways.
Yeah, okay. Well,
go on record.
No,
what were the ways?
Well, he tells somebody to think of a number.
Are you making this up?
No, I'm not. I'm really not. I can't remember. It was years ago.
What? Higher, lower?
Something like that.
Psychological force.
He slapped
I'd like an ace. No, you can't have that one.
He slapped him around the face if the name ace and said, no, that is not the card I want you to name. Name a different card, but not an ace. That's basically what happened.
Is that it? Is that the bonus on the DVD? Yeah.
Well, no, because in Spreadwave 2, you don't have to slap the spectator. You can actually have the ace named.
You can have the ace named. No spectator slapping involved.
No spectator slapping
right, okay.
involved.
Right, okay. And you just spread through. Now, the thing is, it's a gimmick deck.
Really?
Yeah, obviously. Yeah, a completely gimmick
that.
Deck. If you're doing it for real punters, you know, not polite magicians at some awards ceremony in wherever it was in 2006, and mm-hmm. they go, oh, it's very clever, he's come up with a new design of gimmick deck. Yep. What does a spectator think when they see this?
Let me pick these up and have a look at them.
Yeah, that looks like a nice puzzle pack of cards. Is that what they think? I don't know, I like it.
I don't know.
I do think it's good.
In many ways, I think that this is as good as, if not better than, the Invisible Deck. The Invisible Deck is a wonderful thing because it allows you to name a card and have that card revealed in a pack of cards that is sitting on the table from the beginning.
Better than Invisible Deck.
Well, that's kind of the holy grail for magicians, isn't it? To have a deck of cards sitting on the table and to be able to spread through or be able to show that the one card that was named...
I think the holy grail is probably, and it being a number that you named.
Yeah, that's probably it.
That's probably the
holy
grail.
That's quite a unique plot, isn't it? But that, if you think about it, does the same thing as an Invisible Deck. The deck's put on the table from the beginning, and you can show that the only card they name is revealed in that deck. The difference between this and the Invisible Deck is there's no other cards in play. So with the Invisible Deck, there's one card turned over, but all the other cards are there.
So they think you could have turned it over using sleight of hand.
Maybe they
is that what
think
you're saying?
That. Yeah, but psychologically,
I'm not so sure. I agree, but yeah, I know what you mean.
Psychologically, with this, they spread through, and there is only one card printed. It is the card that they named. It's a beautiful effect.
It's got it's so many... I know, it is good. It does look good. In the perfect,
there
you
know... There you go, enough said.
Magic club competitions where you've got your lovely mat out and that kind of thing, or your big bar, like on Penn & Teller Foolers, and you can go, there's some cards there, and there it is.
You do
there
need a big table, but there's times when you can use a big table. There's times when you've got access to
I suppose you could
those.
Do it on the floor if you wanted to.
You could do it after Matrix.
Don't even get me started on Matrix.
It's almost as beautiful as a Matrix routine.
Yeah, Matrix, yeah. We're not even going to get started on that again. It has got limitations, but if you like the effect, it's not that hard to do either. I thought it was going to be a lot harder. You'd have a lot more to remember. But in actual fact, when you take out the face-up cards that say your card is...
The face-up cards are what cues you the information... Well, not the information, but the positioning that you need in order to accomplish the
And
effect.
The DVD is very good, isn't
it's
it?
It's an amazing instructional DVD. Now, Matthew Beach is French, so that's why everything's done silently to music, and there's instructions put on the DVD.
And you see
and
captions and that kind
excellent.
Of thing. Yeah.
It really is. It's such a well-produced DVD in terms of this is what you do, and all the subtitles go on there. It's really good.
The only thing is, for me, it's not as it's not that commercial, but it is a great trick. If you want to do that trick, it is great. I'm going to give it 87%.
I think that's too low. I think that's too low. I mean, the one issue is you need a big table and it's not examinable.
You've got to have so just that deck. It does that trick. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. It's me. My
it's,
opinion.
It's a beautiful routine.
Yeah. It's beautiful routine. It's a great full Penn and Teller. What are you going to give it?
I what did you give it?
I can't remember now.
What did you give it, John?
87.
I'm giving it 88. It needs an extra percent.
Right, next up is Nathan Kranzo, who is slowly disappearing.
Yeah, he's getting thinner and thinner and thinner and thinner.
Either that or it was filmed in widescreen and then reformatted in 4:3 and he just looks like this.
Yeah, he looks really thin now. But more importantly, for the first time in many years, he's brought out a DVD where you get to see his head.
You do actually get to see his hairstyle on the top of his head, which is very amazing. Exciting. While he does this routine, the easy add a number... by Nathan Kranzo.
Now, I really like that. I've never used an add a number routine before. I've never used an add a number pad. It's not something I've ever done, and I know you know quite a lot about this, and I know very little. And I really like this.
Once.
And everything I said that I like, you're like, yeah, that's been done before.
It has, and I've seen all these methods done before. He has routined them into quite a nice sort of routine. The easiest add a number routine you will ever encounter. Sacrificing none of the entertainment value. Funny, entertaining, and strong stand-up mentalism. This is a closer that fits in your pocket. That is badass.
Fair enough.
That's what it says on the back of the DVD.
Well,
but
for those of you that haven't seen the... the routine, basically what happens is he gets a spectator's watch, he gets them to twizzle the knob, and then...
Is it a spectator's watch or is it his watch?
Yeah, no, you can use a spectator's watch.
In fact,
that principle...
Can you use a digital?
You can't use... It's got to be an analogue watch, but I've used that principle for years. I've seen it first done in Richard Osland.
Yeah, I know, right,
But yeah, he takes a watch and he gets them to set the time without looking at it and put it in a bag. And then he's got a stack of business cards. He gets 5 random people to write down a year.
Yeah, he goes round and goes, there's my business cards.
Yeah.
Write a number down on there.
Yeah, and then he gives it to a sixth person.
And he does the traditional add a number routine.
And then you've got multiple revelations. The revelation is built into the watch, and then you've got the big numbers.
Which has been done before.
You've got the date as well.
Which has been done before. It's like in the Burglass book and all sorts of stuff and that kind of thing. It's a nice routine and that sort of thing. But if you've done this sort of thing before, you're just going to look at it and you're just going to go, why is this a new product? His patter wasn't particularly sort of groundbreaking. I don't know. I've liked so much of Nathan's stuff, you know, but...
You weren't too keen on this?
I weren't too keen on this.
But I have no
knowledge. I don't know what's been brought to the table.
I have no knowledge about add a number routines before. I thought that the way he was using regular business cards was unique. Is that...
Well, I think I've seen that before. I'm sure I've seen that. You know, stack thing with going around with a stack of business cards. And I'm sure I've seen that before.
Right.
I might be wrong, but I'm sure I've seen it before. Somebody's done it in a lecture.
Well, when you were watching it, you were telling me exactly what
I told you I was doing it straight away. Yeah. Because I've seen it before. I don't know where, but I've seen it before. Not that I'm looking to be fooled, but I was looking to see something unique.
You've got to admit,
that was
it is an
worthy
routine.
Of the put. Yeah, what was particularly entertaining about it? Tell me now.
Two live performances.
Yeah, okay, that happens all the time.
And it was entertaining. He was funny.
What was entertaining and funny? What bits?
The bit where he was talking to the spectators.
That original script that you'd only get on this DVD?
No, not really. The revelations were really...
Unoriginal. Yeah. Nicely routine, three different revelations altogether.
Yeah.
But if you watched a demo, a full demo of the whole thing, you could just go, oh yeah, it's an all right routine. I could do that.
You know, I'm sitting here and I really want to argue with you, but I can't think of anything to say. I really want to argue with you.
That's because I'm right.
I want to be the Nathan Kranzo fan club and I want to argue
back
with you.
It's good. It's a good routine, but if I'm going to put my hand in my pocket, spend money on it, that's going to drop through the letterbox and it comes and I go, do you know what? It's all right. Yeah, but nothing new.
The one thing I would say about it is... there's so many DVDs out these days. There's so many multi-effect DVDs. What gives this...
What are you trying to say? It's nice to get a one-trick DVD now.
No, what I'm trying to say, I'm actually arguing
with
you.
It's great to have a one-trick DVD. That's what we need.
I'm trying to say...
So many of these multi-effect DVDs with so much material on, where they just devalue the tricks because they're only worth £2 each. What you need is one DVD with one trick that's worth £20.
That's the point I was trying to make, but in reverse, I was trying to say, I don't think it should be a single trick DVD. I think it should have gone on a whole...
So you're not happy with it then?
It could be better. It could be better. We did that Alpha Wallet last week or the week before.
Yeah.
And that had an add a number routine on it with the dictionary.
Yeah, but that was so many different things. And it was the actual use of the wallet that was original, not the routine.
Mm-hmm.
It was the wallet that made it very commercial.
I can't argue with you. I so want to argue with you, but I can't because you're totally right. And it's annoying. I wish you weren't right.
There's just nothing new. Yeah, it's good. It's a commercial routine. Every revelation I've seen used before.
So basically...
You know, accumulated the whole thing, put it into quite a nice routine.
And then whacked it on a DVD for £20.
And then he's put it on a DVD and he probably maybe does it in lectures and goes, here's the routine if you've forgotten it, you didn't bring your notepad. But other than that, I don't know. Not that excited. You know, it's not like moving a tan line up your arm. It's a miracle.
Yeah.
That's just like an add a number routine with a few bits of paper at the end.
Yeah.
And how he got the standing ovation from that audience, I don't know.
But he did.
He did, yeah, but you didn't see the rest of the show where he said that his kid was dying and they're desperate for a standing ovation. And if I could just go home tonight and say that I got a standing ovation, it would make my kid's day.
So hang on, let
that
me
was
just
earlier
get
on
straight.
In the show.
Let me just get this
then
right.
Then you just see the performance.
Let me just get this straight.
And he gets his wallet out, looks at the picture of his kid and then goes, see you very...
Let me just get this straight, because I know Nathan Kranzo watches this DVD.
That's what happens.
You're saying the only way...
Halfway through the show, there's a psychological standing ovation hook, you know.
Right, okay.
You missed it on camera where he just looked in his wallet and pointed at his kid.
Views of the Wizard Product Review, that's official from David Penn, that the
I don't
only
believe
way,
it.
Official
I challenge Nathan Kranzo...
To get a standing ovation with that routine.
With that routine in the UK.
Without saying that his kid's dying.
Yes, absolutely. I don't believe it happens. Sorry. I'm giving it 68%.
Hang on. That's quite high mark considering you're a whole... Hang on.
You're
saying it's not original. It's not worth the money. It's not good enough to get a standing ovation.
No, I said it's quite a good commercial routine. Just because I've seen it all before, I've got to judge it on... You know, just somebody that wants an add-a-number routine. Is it a good add-a-number routine? Yeah, it's going to work. You stick 5 minutes in your cabaret. No problem, it's going to work. That's why it gets that mark.
Right, fair enough.
That's for me.
Well, I'm going to give it slightly more. I'm going to give it 75%. I think it's better than what you're making out.
Why?
Just shut up. Shut up. 75%, end of.
But you don't know why.
No, I haven't got a clue.
Right, here we go with a miracle from Henry Evans. We're not going to get it off the sticks. We've got a live audience here that have not seen this.
Yeah, just to set the scene, I walked in this morning and David got here at the crack of dawn with Blammo and he'd already started opening stuff up and looking at it. And this is something that he said that I had to watch on the show for the first time in order to get a genuine reaction.
Here we go.
He is the man that can do an S-fan and yet not a riffle force.
Say stop.
Stop.
Okay, look at that one.
That was good.
Don't show me. In fact, leave it face down on your hand. Do not let me see that card at all. Would you be amazed if I could tell you that card?
Not really.
It'd be amazing, wouldn't it, if I could tell you that card?
Yeah,
right,
it would
okay.
be astounding.
It's a red card or a black card, obviously. Right, I'm going to go for the Four of Hearts.
No, Dave, that's not right. It's not the Four of Hearts.
Oh, God. It's the Five of Clubs. Right, let's have a little hilarious piece of comedy right now. Here we go.
Oh, that's
look at this. It never normally goes wrong, folks. It never normally goes wrong. Sorry, hang on to that piece just there. But let's see if we can fix this with an amazing piece of magic. Hold on to that just there, Craig.
Okay.
What I'm going to do is take the empty glass. Let me just get some of these bits out. So I'm just going to scoop. I'm just scooping. Just scooping some bits. So got all the bits. Here we go. Sorry, a bit too many bits. Sod off. Stay just there.
You gotta be bloody kidding me.
You ready? And too many bits. Stay just there.
Okay.
Whoa.
And look. And they do actually match.
Come back on and Wongle is forgiven. Are you serious? Are you serious?
That's good. It's just under 50 quid.
This what? How much is this? How much is John, how much is this?
I think it's about 50 quid.
Just really?
Under 50 10 quid. Seconds.
Really? Yeah, go check on the computer. He's checking on the computer.
Just under 50 quid.
What?
It's a bargain. You get the hanky, you get the bag.
Where you off to?
I'm going to get the box.
Oh.
Look. Here it is. Instant card restoration.
Hang on, this is just... Is this going to become a trend on the Wizard Product Review? You make me look at a rubbish trick for the first time and then pretend it's absolutely amazing. Come on.
£55.
55 quid! What a bargain!
That's cheap.
55 quid, what do you get for that?
You get that beautiful moment of magic where
okay,
you...
let me ask you a question. Do you get the glass?
Yeah. Yeah.
Do you get the hanky?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah, I can see that. Do you get the bag?
Yeah.
Do you get all the bits of card?
Yeah.
Do you get the other secret something?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Does the secret something always look as bad as it did?
You get the DVD.
Okay.
What? Two bits of A4 paper with all pictures on, how to learn it.
You get a DVD.
No DVD. Sorry,
I was about to say, how does the DVD
fit? No, you don't get a DVD.
That would be a better trick than that
one. I was looking for a DVD.
Look, I've watched this for the...
Yeah, but... Put it all down. It's one of the... You know, Geoffrey Durham lectured, right? Geoffrey Durham.
Don't bring Geoffrey Durham and this trick.
Durham said, because I was listening, the best tricks happen right there in front of your face.
Not when right you're crap.
Right there, and the moment of magic in your face.
No. Right, look, Nick, just look. Let's just get down from cloud cuckoo land and come back to reality for a minute, shall we? And let's just talk about this trick.
I liked it.
I watched it for the...
Did you like it, John?
Yeah. John.
That
John.
Would be great.
Brilliant. Miracle.
Right, John, did you like it?
Yes.
Did you like it?
Yeah, I love
You're lying. Let's just get back to reality right now. Let's just talk about this. I don't care what you think. It's rubbish, right? Look, when... I'm sure you guys saw what I saw. When the cards... Look, right, give me some of these. Right, look. When these are in here... Like this.
It looked just like that.
It looks absolutely nothing like what you were showing me. It looked like a little tube with printed pieces of card on.
No.
And that's exactly... Look, you put... Right, rewind the Wizard Product Review to when he was holding the glass like this. And tell me if that looks anything like what it looked like in the performance. That wouldn't fool a blind monkey. That wouldn't fool anybody. Look at it. That wouldn't fool.
I got a genuine standing ovation.
How much did you pay them?
Nathan Kranzo's was fake, but I got a genuine one.
Bull. Right. Just no way. This is just totally rubbish, Dave.
Worker of the week.
No, I'm not letting you do that. No. We'll lose all integrity overnight. There's no way this is worker of the... Trash of the week, maybe. I'd go so far as that. But
it's only 50 quid.
It's 50 quid for a little plastic glass, a rubbish little gimmick that wouldn't fool a blind man, and a piece of silk hanky that you can get for...
Facebook, we're going to... Can we do a poll? On Facebook?
Yeah.
That is worth 50 quid of anybody's money next week. Seriously. everybody's going to go on and support me and say it's
no,
a miracle.
No. There's no
You'll
way.
You'll vote, won't you, Keith?
Yeah.
You're going to vote.
No, there's no way I'm going to lose this. Look at it. It is rubbish. For a start,
just vote on our
Facebook page. Like when you were tipping those little pieces out, it was just obvious, Dave. It was obvious. Okay, here you go. You tip those back in and make it look just like...
A good magician never repeats the same trick. Jesus, he doesn't even know that.
It's one of these shows today, isn't it?
I thought he was experienced.
Back to basics.
Should have stayed.
Yeah, basic. You need to go and get the easy to MasterCard miracle set out. You do, if you don't even know that.
Come on.
Well, let the people on Facebook decide.
So we're not rating it?
No, we're not rating
it. Good job. You know why?
No, you can't. You can't influence people. They've seen the performance.
I promise.
They've listened to your very petty arguments.
Oh!
Ouch. And we'll leave it up to them to decide. I trust the viewers of the Wizard Product Review.
So do I.
That they know a miracle when they see it. Slow it down. It's a beautiful moment of magic. Right, final review this week is Miracle, signed card in envelope with bonus routines. Finally, a card to envelope you will always use.
Yeah, okay. Roger Cousin. Sorry, can we start that again? I just completely...
Well, no, carry on.
You've been bullying me the whole show and I just...
I don't know. Yeah, it is Roger Cousin's signed... Well, thanks for your input, Craig. Shall I carry on? Basically, you have a card chosen, signed from a blue pack, and then you show your utility bill envelope.
Yeah.
You don't get a utility bill envelope with it. You get a nice white sort of manila envelope, but you could make it with a utility bill. And then straight away, you've got a card in there, which is a different colour to the one they signed. You pull it out, and it's their signed card, and the back's changed.
That pretty much sums it up.
And it's very clean.
Yeah, it is very clean. Yeah.
It's good. I actually liked it. You were saying to me, that's been out before, that's David Regal's trick, you know, special
delivery. It does look very similar to Special Delivery by David, the man, Regal.
I know this has been out years, and I know Roger has been doing this for years.
Are you saying for fact that it's definitely been out before, Roger Curzon has been doing it before David Regal?
You know, I don't want people handbags at dawn and that kind of thing.
Has he actually released this as an effect before?
Yes, I'm sure he has. But I bought this when it was just like a manuscript and a...
Okay.
But they've done a good job now. They've produced it with a DVD, that sort of thing. You do get an envelope with it, which is set up to do the effect straight away.
Well, it teaches you how to make it up out of a window envelope. And following the instructions, you can make it up in about 5 or 6 minutes.
It is really, really clean. The same card comes out of the envelope. It just looks like
I wasn't too keen on his ambitious card, which was the second routine.
No, one thing he does, which is a little bit weird.
It's less of a presentation and more of a narrative.
He does his ambitious card routine, and then he shows the envelope in the wallet, doesn't he? And you can see the card in the envelope at that point. And then he says it's going to rise up and go into the envelope. And it's like, well, the card was already there.
Yeah.
So it didn't make too much sense. And I'm sure with that envelope...
You could show it empty first.
You could show it empty first. And then as you close the wallet, kind of like set it up. I'm sure you could do that.
I can't see any reason.
I'm sure that would be better.
Yeah, Betty.
Better, yeah. So I got distracted there because
John's holding up signs
and that kind of thing.
We're just totally not with it today, or at least I'm not. What was the sign?
3 minutes left on battery.
You better
hurry this up.
Hang on. Stop the tape. We're back.
Nobody noticed.
Right, okay. So,
what were you saying? The ambitious card I didn't like.
But it didn't make sense. I'm sure you could set it up.
The actual main routine I thought was very good. Very similar to sudden delivery, special delivery, but... Whatever.
And there's some bonus routines.
Now, the bonus routines I really like. There's two bonus routines. I'm going to go off a little bit on these.
Which are nothing to do with sign cards.
No, they're not. Two bonus routines. Now, the first reminds me very much of Election by Eric Ross, but he doesn't have to have any special preparation of the cards. If you've seen Election by Eric Ross, it's a do-as-I-do routine where they pick a card, turn it over, the cards in each other's packs match, but then the cards have transposed as well. He's managed to achieve something very similar to that, but there's no setup, there's no gimmicking of the deck, unlike Eric's routine. And the second one, the second bonus routine, absolutely...
I think, yeah, I know, it fooled you. What do you do for a living?
I'm a magician.
Yeah, it's a magician fooler. It's boring as hell for spectators. Back to the... Yeah, I think it's boring.
Really?
Yeah, come on. Come on. Why were you impressed?
Because I didn't know how it worked.
That's why he was impressed. He was all right. The first routine, I agree with you. The thing with all
the... do as I do was commercial.
The do as I do was very commercial.
You even said, quote, I think I'd like to do that, unquote. Or something along those lines. Maybe not an exact quote, but you're getting there.
Yeah, maybe. I think it was... I might have a go of it during the Pipe and Slippers moment and that kind of thing. I thought it was...
Well, after you've done Matrix.
I thought it was quite good, but the other routine I didn't like. But the main thing, the Miracle Sign Card and Envelope...
The Miracle Sign Card and Envelope is very good. And what's nice about it is you can have the envelope on the table from the beginning. You can get the card picked. It can be... It's really... Speak for me.
Good.
It's good.
You liked it.
Yeah, it's really good.
I don't know what's up with him.
I don't know
today,
what's up with me today.
At all. I'm the one that's only had 7 hours sleep in three days.
I didn't get much sleep over the weekend.
I don't know. I like this. If you like the effect, you're not going to be disappointed. It looks as clean as it does on the video as the card
is
taken out.
And what's nice is, you know, everybody... Right, I'm back on track now. No, I'm not. Yes, I am. Magicians use card to wallet all the time, and I think it's a little bit overused. It's done
yeah,
as a finale.
Sophisticated leather wallets. You don't want that. You want a nice, grubby utility bill envelope.
No,
that'd be
better. The point I'm trying to make
I'm just like throwing you off
card
track.
To wallet is overused.
It is.
People use it.
How many times have you been out there and the spectators go, not that card to wallet routine? Which
it
one
happens
are you using?
All the time, doesn't it?
Are you using the JOL or are you using a Himba? You know, so many people, they've all seen it when you're out there, aren't they?
I give up, I really
In fact, it's more like a lecture when you're working these days, isn't it? You just have to sit down with a spectator. They go, is that real leather like a JOL or...
Just give up, I can't.
What percentage are you going to give it?
Look, I think it should be Worker of the Week.
Better than Henry Evans?
Yes, better than Henry Evans. It is a worker.
I do
Come
like
on.
It.
Right, the plus point.
If you it's like
an,
it...
It's an instant reset.
Yeah.
There's no angle considerations. You don't need a table. It's easy to do. And it's impressive. And there's more than one routine.
If you could do the bit where you show it empty and then set it, which I'm sure you can, I would give it Worker of the Week.
Yeah, so we've agreed. Worker of the Week, not Henry Evans.
Well, I don't know. That will lead to the spectators. The viewers of the Wizard Product Review, the spectator. They have been spectating on the screen. So, Miracle Sign Card and Envelope. How much are you going to give it?
I'm giving it 91%. If you've got sudden delivery, special delivery, if you've got that trick by David Regal, you might want to not consider it because it is similar. But having said that, there are a lot of other applications that you can use for it as well.
Two nice bonus routines as well.
Two very good bonus routines. Hang on, so you agree that it's a nice bonus routine?
Yeah, well, they're nice routines, but one of them's particularly good.
91%.
I'll give it 89%. I'm not going into the 90s for it, but it is very commercial if you like it. I'll agree with the Worker of the Week.
Thank you.
That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. Anything
not,
else
not,
to
yeah,
add?
There's a whole bunch to talk about. First of all, we need to talk about lads.
Lads and lads this year is going to be even bigger.
It's going to be even better. Last year, when we planned Lads, it's everybody knows.
We spent ages planning it, didn't we?
You wrote the running order down on a napkin.
Yeah, this year's going to be bigger. It's going to be bigger.
We're going to use two napkins.
We're going to use two napkins, yeah.
And we'll maybe even upgrade to a piece of paper.
The lineup will be on Facebook the week before because people are going to ask us, who have you got booked this year?
Hang on. Who have you got booked this year?
It's been finalised as we speak because we want it to be big and we want it to be special.
He rang me up at midnight last night and he said, you got to ring this person, you got to ring this person. I was on the phone until 2 o'clock in the morning.
But we're making inquiries and
we've
got people
coming
over, we're booking flights and that kind of thing.
There's a very good chance we might be contacting you.
There's a very good chance. And if we have contacted you and you're ignoring us, can you get back to us? Because we've got to get it sorted.
You know who you are.
And last year we had a bit of criticism, like it sold out, didn't it, last year? And we had a bit of criticism that the place wasn't so good.
The place wasn't so good. It was
like an episode of Phoenix Nights, wasn't it?
It was rough around the edges, to say the very least.
But this year, we've gone upmarket, folks. We're going to the Ramada Hotel, and it's very, very posh. We've got our own function room, staging, video screens, and that kind of thing. And we'll have loads of dealers there as well. And the best news is, it costs like next to nothing.
It does cost next to nothing, yeah.
Because you buy a ticket for £15, you register, but on the day you get a £10 voucher back for World Magic Store's stand. Yep. So it costs you like a fiver for the whole day of lectures and dealers.
Which is amazing. But there's one question that every single person that's watching the Wizard Product Review wants to know. And I'm going to ask it for them now, and I want you to answer it honestly. David Penn, at Lads this year, is Blammo going to be there?
Blammo is going to... I don't know if he's allowed in.
We can't not have Blammo.
Can we get him a vest that says Guide Dogs in Training?
Yes. Yeah.
We can do that, can't we? Yeah.
And on behalf
If you can make that, if anybody out there is good with a sewing machine, Guide Dogs in Training on the side, we'll get him inside.
That would work, actually. That would probably work.
And works in Tesco.
On behalf of Blammo, I'd like to just say thank you to all of his new friends.
He's now got
almost 4,000 friends on his Facebook page. He doesn't know what to do about it, so... from Blammo, he'd like to say woof. So
yeah. No, it's Yap. He normally says Yap.
Yeah.
That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review.
Yeah, no, there's one more thing we need to address.
What's that?
True Astonishments.
True Astonishments.
You went on YouTube and you promised everybody that we would be reviewing the True Astonishments box set, and I've had nothing for grief for the last 4 weeks.
Don't care that I've had 7 hours sleep in 3 days, do you?
Not really, no.
Right, okay. So what are you asking
for? Right, they all want to know when we're doing the True Astonishments set review, because we promised it 4 weeks ago and it still hasn't come, Everybody wants to know when we're going to be looking at Paul Harris's box set.
So you want the official update right
now? I want the official update.
Okay. Soon.
There's the official update from the Wizard Product Review.
It's coming soon.
It's a big DVD set. There's like so many DVDs.
And we can't find all the Easter eggs.
No, we're not
going to
review it until we've found every single one of them.
We might have to ring Paul up again and say, come on, tell us where they are. He said, you know, have a bit of fun. Try and find the Easter eggs. Yeah. I don't know where they are. I don't know. I'm trying to find the Easter eggs.
That's probably the best Paul Harris impression I've ever heard. It's just amazing. It was like just watching him.
I don't know. That's it for the Wizard Product Review for this week.
That's pretty much it.
There's nothing else to discuss, is there? We were going to mention that guy, David J. He'll be at Lads as well, doing some stuff.
We're going to have some nice releases at Lads as well. We're going over to Spain soon. We talked about it last week.
Doing some filming, doing our DVD in Vegas. We got something coming out with like a very organic version of the Haunted Pack.
Yeah, which is very good. But the thing I'm most excited about is that coin trick. That coin trick is amazing.
But we can't tell
anybody about that. I had the prototype and I've been working it, and it is just beautiful.
Is that going to be out for Lads?
It better
be. Really going to be out for Lads? I thought that was a Blackpool release. Don't say any more on that. I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
That was the Wizard Product Review for this week.